Okay, we'll start. I think total 11 participants are there. We'll not wait for some more time. So we'll start with this session. Okay, we're not going to recall anything regarding the previous lecture, what we have learned. Yes. Okay, no problem. Okay, we'll start with the lecture. Okay, now tell me, my screen is visible to all? Yes, is it visible? Meenakshi, Pooja, Smita?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Okay, so without wasting much time, we'll continue with the next principle of management, which is given by the Henry Fayol. That is the 8th principle of management. Okay. I'll just try to read this. And tell me, what do you understand by after reading this? The 8th principle given by the Henry Fayol, that is centralization and decentralization. Okay. We already studied this in the functions of management. Okay, it was related to decision making and all. So the Fayol defined centralization as lowering the importance of the subordinate's role. Decentralization is increasing the importance. Okay, see, Fayol defined centralization as what it lowers. It lowers the importance of subordinate role, and decentralization is increases the importance of subordinate. Subordinate means what? Subordinates means employees who are working in that institution, in that organization. Okay, now tell me, so what is meaning of centralization? It lowers the importance of employees, and decentralization, it increases the importance of employees. So what do you understand by after reading this first point? Okay, just try to tell me, what do you understand by centralization and decentralization? Okay, we'll give you one example, don't worry. I'm announcing that on tomorrow I'm going to take one test. So whatever syllabus of 201 we have completed till now, I'm going to conduct one test. Okay, so this is the decision. See, centralization and decentralization. Yes, Komal, you want to answer? See, so this is the decision taken by me. Okay, but if I am taking the decision, so while taking any decision regarding the test condition, if I am considering you all, I am taking opinions from you people, so that decision, it can be decentralized decision. So whenever I am taking opinions from your side, so automatically I am giving importance to you also. Okay. And in centralization, so just recall, try to recall my previous statement. Tomorrow I'm going to conduct one test. So that is the decision taken by a teacher. Yes, I'm a teacher. So if we see the levels of manager, I comes under lower level manager. So here decision is taken by Pratibha ma'am. So that decision is centralized decision. So automatically we can say the centralized decision, it lowers the importance of subordinate, and decentralized decision is low, it increases the importance of subordinate. See, there are different names for the employees. The subordinate, that is nothing but the employees who are working in that institution, isn't it? Understood this? Should I move ahead? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Decision making to be carried out in a centralized manner. Decisions are always taken by the higher level manager, whereas decision should be executed by the lower level manager. See, so according to the Henry Fayol, so who supposed to take decision? Yes? Yes? Just try to read this, just read this second point.
Higher level manager.
So decision, so according to Henry Fayol, see, basically this Henry Fayol, he focuses on the centralization process. So see, whenever we are talking about the centralization, decentralization, means it related to the decision making. Okay, but here what Henry Fuller says, he focuses on the centralization process of decision making. So decisions are always taken by the higher level managers, and whereas the whatever decisions are taken by the higher level managers, all the decisions are executed by. अगर मैंने आपको बोला you have to give test tomorrow only, there is no any other options. So as a lower level manager, it's your duty to obey my rule. Okay, so that is nothing but the decision, centralized process of decision making. The degree to which centralization and decentralization should be adopted depends on the specific organization in which the manager is working. So he basically, Henry Fuller focuses on the centralized process of decision making, but he also saying that it depends on the manager and in which organization he is working. So according to the situation, he can take centralized or decentralized decision, but as per the Henry Fuller, he is supposed to take centralized process of decision making. Okay. Just wait for a while. Okay. The next principle, understood previous one? That is centralization. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Meenakshi. See, the next is scalar chain. Okay. Just read it once and tell me what you understand by after reading this slide. Yes. Now it's your turn. I want interactions from your side also. Yes. Okay, who will tell me what do you understand after reading this slide?
Ma'am, scalar chain means there is a chain, like one authority will give a certain amount of authority. Matlab, kuch authority we will give to the others, to the lower persons. So we can interact, we both can interact and take a decision like this.
You're partially correct. Yeah. See, if we see, as you know, there are different levels of managers. Okay. Just consider any education institution. It can be school, it can be college. Okay. And just think about the different levels of managers. So just now tell me. So of course, there is a, we can see, we can draw different levels of managers on the basis of authority. So how much authority that particular person is having as per that. So who will come in the topmost level?
Yes. Management.
Very nice. The management will come under topmost level. We can say the trustee members, in short. Yes. After management, there is a second authorized person. Who is that person?
Principal.
Yes. Yes, Archana, you are correct. Principal. And after principal?
Teacher.
See, if you are talking about the school, so there is different post of as per the authority.
So coordinator, vice principal.
Yes, there can be coordinator, then can be vice principal. Okay. After vice principal, yes, there can be supervisor. After supervisor, yes, there are the teachers. Okay. Teachers. Teacher, in short, we can say teaching and non-teaching staff. Okay. And after yes, that, the students and parents. So this is the authority chain, we can say. The managers in hierarchies are part of the chain, like authority. So this is the authority scale. In short, we can say authority chain. We can say each manager from the first line supervisor to the president. So here, in short, they are giving the hierarchy. Okay, possesses certain. So each level manager, he is having certain amount of authority. Okay, the president possesses the most. See, the president is, of course, he is at the topmost level, so he possesses the most authority. And the frontline supervisor, he possesses the least authority. And here, the lower level managers should always keep upper level manager informed of their work activities. Okay. So what is duty of lower level manager? Keep informing to the higher level authority. But here, the Henry Fuller, he basically focuses on the flow of communication. Of course, there is a hierarchy in the authority. you can say the chain in the authority or the what amount of authority particular level is possessing, it depends on that. So here he basically focuses on the flow of communication, and according to him, there is only one way process. Okay, so here we are talking about, I'm going to repeat. So he believe on the one way process of communication, means what? The higher level manager should give orders to the lower level manager. वहां पे रिवर्सिबल नहीं है, देखो वहां पे सिंगल वन वे प्रोसेस है, वहां से ये नहीं आ रहा है. सो आफ्टर डूइंग हिज एक्टिविटी, दैट इज द जॉब ऑफ द लोअर लेवल मैनेजर, दैट ही सपोज टू इन्फॉर्म द हायर लेवल मैनेजर, इजंट इट?
यस मैम.
अंडरस्टूड अबाउट दिस स्केलर चेन?
यस
यस मैम.
ओके, सी मैनेजमेंट, देन प्रिंसिपल, देन वाइस प्रिंसिपल, देन सुपरवाइजर, देन टीचिंग एंड नॉन टीचिंग स्टाफ, एंड देन students and parents. Okay, the next principle of management is order. Now it's your turn, just try to read it, and what do you understand by this, just tell me. Yes, so where we can correlate, see in the previous lecture we have studied, previous to previous lecture we have studied some functions of management. So can we correlate this order principle of management with a particular function of management? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Just tell me name of that function of management.
Organization.
Okay.
Unit in command.
Yes.
Unit in command.
See, we saw.
Discipline. Coordinating, I think coordinating or cooperating.
I'm repeating one. See, the important line is
man staffing.
Right man. See, I'm going to repeat. Right man in the right place for the right job. Right man. So something, this sentence, it is talking about the selection procedure. So selection of the employees means it is related to
man direct and controlling.
No. We are talking about the selection of the person, means selection of the staff who will be the part of that organization. It's related to staffing, and the second is organizing.
I said no, ma'am. Organizing and staffing.
Who said that?
Archana Kulkarni.
Archana, okay. Very nice, Archana. See, it's related to staffing, means order means right man in the right place for the right job. And here what he did, he laid emphasis on the optimum utilization of the available resources. So previously we saw this in the organization. Okay, so there should be allocation of the task is done. The main motto behind that is optimum utilization. So here we have to select the right person for the right place for the right job. That is nothing but the order principle of management given by the Henry Fayol. Okay, so just how we can correlate this optimum utilization with this, the previous sentence, the first, this statement that order means right man in the right place for the right job. Can anyone try to elaborate? Yes.
If excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Archana.
Here, ma'am, one right person should be there, and he has to give the work to the employer as a right way of a work. That's depend.
See, in the previous principle, we saw the authority. Okay, even the order, unity of command, unity of direction. So these are the different functions. But here we are talking about the how we can correlate this optimum utilization with right man in the right place for the right job. Suppose, I will give you one example. Suppose I'm science teacher, but instead of science, if the management or the principal, he told me, nahin, kal se aapko mathematics padhana hai, because mathematics is your second method. Am I give my all the potential in that while teaching that particular subject? Is it? No, because no. Basically I'm science teacher. So
yes.
Here, if my first method is science teacher, if my all the background, I did my graduation as well as PG in the science background. So basically I'm a science teacher. So science subject I can teach very nicely. So that is nothing but the optimum utilization. It means the right man in the right place for the right job. Understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sure. Okay. Equity. Equity. All employees should be treated as equally as possible. सभी को बोलते हैं equity means समानता. You have to treat each and every person. See, all employees. Not we are talking about any particular level of employees. So we are the part of that organization or that institution. All should be treated equally. There should not be biasness. Okay.
Yes.
So here, so see the higher level manager, that our higher level managers should treat the lower level managers equally. Agar yahan pe principal hai, principal should treat equally with all the teachers as well as non-teaching staff. Even we are talking about the teachers, teachers should treat equally all the
students.
Yes, all the students. So this is the equality, or you can say equity function of the not function, it is the characteristics, equity characteristics, or you can say the principle of management given by the Henry Fayol. Understood this? This is very simple principle. See, in the final examination, even though in your prelim examination, this question will come for the this will be the full length question for the 15 marks. Okay. And the question will be, you have to just describe all the principles of management given by the Henry Fayol and actual its applicability in the school education. You have to give examples regarding each principle, isn't it? Okay. The next principle is stability of tenure of personnel. Means what? Just read it. अभी मुझे देखना है सबसे पहले कौन आंसर देता है आपको क्या समझ में आया आफ्टर रीडिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड और डू यू अंडरस्टूड
हेलो
यस
मैम दिस इज रिगार्डिंग
फर्स्ट टेल मी योर नेम Okay, Minal.
Minal Pagare.
Yes, Minal. Please speak.
Ma'am, this is related to the general interest should be the first preference rather than personal interest of the employee. Means high priority, that line is shown high priority.
See, here we are talking about, see the word stability of the tenure of personal. Okay. Who will try?
It's regarding the job security. Means the productive employee, the job should be more secured.
See, agar main aapko ek example de rahi hu. Agar suppose B.Ed hone ke baad, agar aap kisi school mein aapka selection hota hai, aur uske baad agar aapko ye pata hai ki nahi, aapka bond sign kiya gaya only for the 11 month, to aapko kya hoga? Are you having secure job? Of course not. अगर आपका जॉब सिक्योर नहीं है तो क्या आप आपका 100% दे सकते हो
नहीं
हाँ उन्होंने आपका सिलेक्शन आपको पता नहीं है कि आपको कितने आपको रखा भी जाएगा तो जनरली ईयर एंडिंग होता है तो ऑटोमेटिकली टेंशन बढ़ जाता है क्योंकि आपको पता नहीं कि आपको निकाल देंगे या आपको वहीं पे रखेंगे
मैम इट्स लाइक गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स
is government
previously it was like that as employees were more, much more secure that there will not be any termination not any frequent changes and which organization whenever an employee is appointed for a job
okay
he or she whatever will not be removed from his position as frequently as in private
very true
there will be there is sense of security And when the security is been satisfied,
yes.
the employee will produce will work with much productivity.
Actually, they will do their 100%. They will do their work efficiently. Okay. So this principle is simply, it is talking about the job. Very nice, Sonal. Very nice.
Thank you, ma'am. Sonal.
Okay, Sonal Godbole.
Yes, very ma'am. Nice.
Okay. See, basically, he stresses on the job security. Okay. बहुत बार ऐसे ही होता है क्या कि प्रिंसिपल को फ्रीक्वेंटली निकाल दिया?
नहीं मैम.
तो ये मोस्टली मोस्टली किसके साथ होता है? ये
प्रोफेसर्स के साथ,
टीचर्स के साथ होता है. Yes, so that's the reason. Even the
library is also kind of permanent.
See, library? No. See,
librarians also permanent, ma'am. I've seen in my college when I was in graduation and PG. I've done all this all from same college, okay. And for 5 years there was the same librarian, but always professors used to change.
Okay, देखो ये आपको जैसे एक्सपीरियंस आया है उसी के अकॉर्डिंगली आप बोल सकते हो, ठीक है?
Yes,
लेकिन अगर मैंने एक्सपीरियंस किया है कि हमारे यहाँ पे, फॉर एग्जांपल वी विल टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ अवर कॉलेज. सी, वी आर नॉट गेटिंग प्रॉपर क्वालिफाइड लाइब्रेरियन. सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, अगर क्वालिफाइड नहीं मिल रहा है तो ठीक है, क्वालिफाइड नहीं है विदाउट नेट सेट, आप उसको हायर करो तो उसको आप नहीं रख सकते, ठीक है? दैट इज द अनदर पार्टी, दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन इज नॉन क्वालिफाइड. तो यहाँ पे कोई MIT निकाल नहीं रहा है क्योंकि वो सामने वाला पर्सन ही क्वालिफाइड नहीं है, ठीक है? अगर वो क्वालिफाइड होता
तो मैम, अगर क्वालिफाइड अगर है ही नहीं तो उसको जॉब ही नहीं लगेगी ना.
नहीं नहीं, कभी कभी नाइला, मतलब क्या होता है, नाइला होता है बहुत बार. ऐसे होता है, मिलता ही ना पर्सन. अगर आप ऐसे बोल रहे हो, आप मुझे बताओ हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम यूर, दे आर वर्किंग इन द स्कूल, आर यू हैविंग BEd डिग्री? बट स्टिल इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग BEd डिग्री, देन स्टिल ऑल्सो यू आर वर्किंग इन द स्कूल.
In that case, they will not have a good pay skill.
See, that is another criteria, whether you are getting good pay skill or not. But actually, as per the rule, if you are going in the teaching profession, you should have minimum professional degree, at least BA, MA. That is the criteria of qualification. Only the graduation or PG, it is not the criteria of qualification, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. So, see, I'm going to repeat, the FIOL stresses on job security so that all lower level managers, basically यहाँ पे frequently changes करने की किसको होता है, lower level managers. Higher level authority रहती है उसको, उतना उनका job secure रहता है, stable रहता है. So that if there is a job security, then they can concentrate on their work. See, again the word is retaining. Retaining productive employee should always be a high priority of the management. हाँ, तो जो productive work कर रहे हैं उनको हमेशा क्या होना चाहिए, उनका जॉब सिक्योर्ड होना ही चाहिए. ओके, रिटेंशन मींस क्या, एक जगह पे रुकना, रिटेन. ओके, दैट इज द रिटेंशन. सो इफ द एम्प्लॉई वर्किंग इन दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दे शुड हैव जॉब सिक्योरिटी, दे शुड हैव रिटेंशन इन द पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके, रिक्रूटमेंट सिलेक्शन कॉस्ट आर यूजुअली एसोसिएटेड विद हायरिंग न्यू वर्कर्स. अगर वहां पे देखो, वहां पे अगर आप कोई जॉब छोड़ता है तो ऑटोमेटिकली वहां पे वैकेंट पोस्ट है उसके लिए न्यू वर्कर्स को हायर किया जाएगा. सो ऑटोमेटिकली यहाँ पे क्या होगा, रिक्रूटमेंट कॉस्ट आएगा, सिलेक्शन कॉस्ट आएगा, क्योंकि देयर आर सो मेनी राउंड्स, यू हैव टू क्वालिफाइड ऑल द राउंड्स, इंटरव्यू राउंड, फर्स्ट इंटरव्यू, सेकंड इंटरव्यू, देन द एक्चुअल डेमो यू सपोज टू कंडक्ट इन द पर्टिकुलर स्कूल. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट राउंड्स, सो इट इज द कॉस्ट. सो इट रिक्वायर द मनी, द सिलेक्शन एंड रिक्रूटमेंट प्रोसेस, इट रिक्वायर द मनी. ओके, सो अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द टेन्योर ऑफ पर्सनल? Yes or no? Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Here security is given, no ma'am. At what limitation, according to their institution only, no ma'am?
Of course, institution, that particular, see, the government or private, that is the another part. But the particular institution and organization, it is job of that particular institution to keep the job security of the employees working in that organization.
Okay,
बहुत बार क्या होता है, अगर आपने कहीं स्कूल में जॉब किया है पहले आपके ग्रेजुएशन के बेसिस पे, तो आपने शायद ही नोटिस किया रहेगा, अगर वहाँ पे फ्रीक्वेंट स्टाफ चेंज होता है तो दैट इज ऑल्सो प्रॉब्लम फॉर द सीनियर स्टाफ ऑल्सो, क्योंकि जो कनेक्शन होता है ना वो टूट जाता है, फिर न्यू एम्प्लॉयज आते हैं, फिर उनको असिस्टेंट टीचर्स करके रखा जाता है, तो उनके साथ ट्यूनिंग होना, फिर से स्टार्ट. मतलब क्या होता है, ABCD आप सीख रहे हो, आपने Z तक सीख लिया, फिर से A से स्टार्ट कर दिया. ओके, दैट्स द रीजन. ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की प्रोडक्टिविटी के लिए बहुत ही धोखादायक होता है ये भी. इसलिए क्या होना चाहिए, जॉब सिक्योर होना चाहिए. दिस इज गुड फॉर एम्प्लॉइज ऑल्सो, दिस इज गुड फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑल्सो. इजंट इट अंडरस्टूड दिस?
ओके मैम. ओके थैंक यू मैम.
ओके द नेक्स्ट इज इनिशिएटिव. द मैनेजमेंट शुड टेक steps to encourage workers initiative, which is defined as new or additional work activity undertaken through self direction. What do you understand by this? Just recall the different principles of management, and can we correlate this initiative principle of management with the different functions of management? Yes, I'm going to highlight the yes. Tell me which functions are these.
That is planning, ma'am.
See, management should take steps to encourage workers' initiative.
Motivating.
Yes, that is nothing. Who said motivating? Just tell me your name. Sonal or Deepik. Deepika Srivastava, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. See, whenever you're talking encouraging, means motivating, and here the direction. But here the word is, that is self-direction. So see, the unit of direction, that is also needed, because that is the way where to go. All employees will go in the same direction if there is a unit of direction. Suppose there is a particular action plan, so all employees, they will follow particular action plan. Management should take step to encourage worker initiative. So whenever there is a motivation, automatically they will take initiative, they will try to do extra work, they will try to do new work or additional work, we can say, undertaken through the self direction. So automatically aapne bahut dekha rahega ki agar if there is any meeting and principal he is going to give different tasks to the different teachers, so wahan pe kya hota hai ki if the particular in meeting, so principal started his meeting by praising someone. अगर उन्हें नहीं नहीं इन्होंने बहुत अच्छा काम किया, लास्ट टाइम हमने ये इवेंट किया था, इनका बहुत ही रोल था, उन्होंने बहुत उनकी वजह से ये प्रोग्राम सक्सेसफुल हुआ. अगर इफ द प्रिंसिपल इज सेइंग द प्रेजिंग वर्ड्स फॉर द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन और फॉर द पर्टिकुलर टीचर, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द मोटिवेशन. एंड इफ दे आर गोइंग टू प्लान सम अदर फंक्शन इन दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन, सो ऑटोमेटिकली दैट टीचर विल टेक इनिशिएटिव, दैट टीचर विल डू एक्स्ट्रा वर्क, इजंट इट? सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द सेल्फ डायरेक्शन. Understood? Yes, sir.
Yes,
no?
ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
And this is the last principle of management, that is esprit de corps. It means the management should encourage harmony and general good feelings among employees. See, this is very important for the. Nowadays we are using this word, that is work culture. So when we can say there is a work culture, of course if there is a harmony, there is a good relationship between different employees, maybe they are at the same level or at the different level, then only we can say yes, there is a good work culture. Work culture अच्छा होना मतलब क्या है, सभी चीजें इतनी अच्छी है वहां पे, मतलब आपको काम करने का मन करना, that is nothing but the work culture. Okay. If there is a harmony and there is a good feeling among the employees, then you can say, and management should encourage. What they encourage? ऐसे होना चाहिए, उसके लिए भी management को support करना चाहिए. So उसके लिए वो क्या कर सकते हैं, अगर उनके personal relations अच्छे से build करने, so what management can do? Just give me one example. आपको पता है कि कभी कभी ऐसे कुछ events रहते हैं, उसके लिए वो family को भी invite करते हैं.
Yes, ma'am. Annual meet.
Yes, annual meet पे वो फैमिली को इनवाइट करते हैं, या फिर बहुत सारे ऐसे होते हैं कि चलो आप अभी ना हम वन डे पिकनिक करेंगे, तो पिकनिक का क्या होता है, दैट इज नॉट एकेडमिक पार्ट, इजंट इट? एकेडमिक पार्ट नहीं, लेकिन एक कोई भी डे है जिसको बच्चों को छुट्टी है, चलो आज हम पिकनिक जाएंगे, रेनी सीजन है, पर्टिकुलर प्लेस डिसाइड करो, वन डे रिटर्न आएंगे. ओके वो क्या होता है, वो किसके लिए होता है, दैट इज नथिंग, दैट इज फॉर मेकिंग गुड रिलेशनशिप्स अमंग द एम्प्लॉयज. और वहां पे तभी हमें पता चलता है, अरे प्रिंसिपल सर ये इतना अच्छा डांस भी करते हैं, वो तभी पता चलता है. ठीक है, तो ऐसे बॉस, अब इवन स्टूडेंट्स को भी आपने देखा रहेगा, टीचर्स का बिहेवियर, टीचर्स का उस दिन का गेटअप देखो, हाँ वो सभी चीजें बहुत सारी मैटर करती है. ठीक है,
यस,
So this is the last principle of management given by the Henry Fayol. That is nothing but the esprit de corps. Okay, understood all the principle. See, management subject, this is very easy. This is vast subject, but this is very interesting and very easy subject. And I'm sure in the final examination, all the students, they will get more than 75 to 80% marks. I'm sure about you. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm going to stop my screen sharing. And now it's your turn. Okay, we have 10 to 12 minutes more. Okay. Okay, just try to recall one principle. I'm going to type here one principles one by one. And it's your duty here to explain each principle of management given by the Henry Fayol with example. Okay, just try to recall. Don't worry about anything. Agar aapka galat bhi hai, don't worry about this. Okay, so what was the first principle of management given by the Henry Fayol?
Division of work.
Yes, division of work. Very nice. Division of work. Okay, division of work means what? Yes. Try to tell, just try to recall the previous point. Division of work means it is related to
authority.
Yes. Division of work means what? So see, big task is it. Okay, we'll enlist all the principles and they will discuss. We'll have a small discussion on all these principles. The second principle is authority. Yes.
And responsibility.
Yes, authority and responsibility. Okay, I'm just writing this in short. Then third principle is
discipline.
Discipline.
Okay, discipline. Then fourth one.
Unity of command.
Unity of command. Fifth one.
Ma'am, I want to ask you something.
Please, Sonal, please ask.
Whenever ma'am in exam when full length questions will be answered will be there, so if they ask 14 principle of management, one has to write it numerically in numerical order.
No, it is not necessary.
They can be interchanged.
Yes, there can be interchange.
Okay,
just you have to write all the principle, that's 14, it huh? You can okay. Change sequence yeah. Doesn't matter. Okay. Okay.
Yeah,
okay. Okay. See why I'm asking with the sequence, because it is easy to recall.
Okay.
बहुत बार क्या होता है, आप अगर ऐसे ही बोलते हो तो बहुत बार आपको याद करना पड़ता है, अरे कौन सा था, भूल जाते हो. ठीक है. हाँ, इसके लिए जस्ट आपको चाहिए तो उसको कैसे रिकॉल करना है वो आप खुद की स्ट्रेटेजी यू कैन अप्लाई. ओके.
अच्छा.
ओके, द नेक्स्ट इज यूनिटी ऑफ
डायरेक्शन.
डायरेक्शन.
यस, यूनिटी ऑफ डायरेक्शन. Next
recommendation.
What? Pardon?
Recommendation, ma'am.
Sonal.
Remuneration.
Yes, that is remuneration. Yes. Remuneration. Okay. आपको एक इसमें miss हुआ है function. कौन सा हुआ है देखो.
Yes, ma'am. Subordination of individual interest to the general interest.
So subordination of
individual interest to the general interest.
Interest to the general interest. Okay.
Penalty.
Penalty? That was not the principle.
Centralization.
Yes.
The centralization next one. And decentralization.
Wait. Centralization. Centralization and decentralization. Okay, next. Yes.
Scholar chain.
That is scholar or
scholar chain.
What is that?
Scholar chain.
Yes, that is scholar chain, not scholar chain. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next.
Order.
Yes, order. Then next.
Equity.
Yes.
Equity.
Equity. Very nice. Okay. And what was the last?
Stability of tenure of personnel.
No.
Initiative. Stability of tenure of boss. Initiative.
Initiative. Initiative. Okay, initiative. Okay, try to recall remaining. Initiative, what was the last?
Stability in the corpse.
Okay. Only one is left there now. Tell me. Stability of?
Tenure of personnel.
Okay. You can write the stability of tenure. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so these are the principles. Yes.
एक बार scalar chain एक बार समझा देंगे.
See, scalar chain, it is nothing. It is related to the authority. Okay. Just keep in mind two words: the flow of authority. Okay. Or what you can say? See, basically, scalar chain means what? Just we'll give one example. The flow of authority goes from top to bottom. Suppose management is there. After management, there is a principal, there is a vice principal. So here the orders are given by the authorities for the, see, authority. So of course the higher level manager, they are having the higher authority. Means they possess the higher authority. And comparatively, the lower level manager, they're possessing the low authority. Okay. But here, so what Fiol is saying, so flow of communication should be in one way. So normally what we are saying, the communication, it should be two-way process. But as per the Henry Fiol, the communication or the flow of communication, it should be only one way. Matlab higher level se lower level tak hi aana chahiye. Okay. But so whatever task the lower level manager, they will complete, they should report the higher level authority. Okay. Understood? Yahan pe kya bataya hai ki higher level jo managers hai, वो क्या करेंगी, वो ऑर्डर्स देंगे. अथॉरिटी, सबसे ज्यादा अथॉरिटी किसको रहेगी? प्रिंसिपल को रहेगी. मैनेजमेंट को रहेगी, मैनेजमेंट के बाद प्रिंसिपल, प्रिंसिपल के बाद सुपर वाइस प्रिंसिपल, वाइस प्रिंसिपल के बाद सुपरवाइजर, सुपरवाइजर के बाद टीचर्स एंड नॉन टीचिंग स्टाफ एंड देन स्टूडेंट्स एंड पेरेंट्स. सो दिस इज द फ्लो ऑफ अथॉरिटी. आप देखोगे तो ऊपर का जो फ्लो है, सबसे अथॉरिटी सबसे ज्यादा किसको है? मैनेजमेंट को. और नीचे आप जैसे जाओगे वहां पे किसको रहेगी अथॉरिटी? कम होती जाएगी अथॉरिटी. ओके. बट हियर द ऑर्डर्स आर गिवन बाय द हायर लेवल मैनेजर्स एंड वॉट एवर ऑर्डर्स आर गिवन बाय द हायर लेवल मैनेजर्स दैट ऑर्डर शुड बी कम्प्लीटेड. अगर यहाँ पे क्या है, कम्युनिकेशन, खाली कम्युनिकेशन कैसे हो रहा है? आपको यू हैव टू सबमिट योर असाइनमेंट ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर डे. इफ आई एम गिविंग यू दिस इंस्ट्रक्शन, दैट इज नथिंग बट द वन वे कम्युनिकेशन. ओके. आपका टास्क क्या है? यू हैव टू कम्प्लीट योर असाइनमेंट बिफोर द डेट ऑफ कम्प्लीशन. आपको क्या करना है, आपका कम्प्लीशन का डेट जो दिया है उसके पहले आपको असाइनमेंट सबमिट कम्प्लीट करना है, सबमिट करना है. ओके. तो यहाँ पे मैंने क्या किया, मैंने ऑर्डर दिया आपको, बिकॉज दैट इज माई अथॉरिटी, आई कैन गिव दैट ऑर्डर. तो मैंने आपको ऑर्डर दिया, यू हैव टू कम्प्लीट पर्टिकुलर असाइनमेंट बिफोर द पर्टिकुलर डेट. सो दैट इज वन वे कम्युनिकेशन. मैंने ये नहीं देखा कि मैंने जो इंस्ट्रक्शन दिए, सपोज इफ आई एम सेंडिंग पर्टिकुलर मैसेज ऑन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, मैं ये नहीं चेक करूंगी आपने वो मैसेज देखा है कि नहीं. मैंने मैसेज दिया है ना, इट्स योर ड्यूटी, यू हैव टू चेक दैट मैसेज, राइट? सो दिस इज द अथॉरिटी इज गोज फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम. अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द अथॉरिटी, द स्कैलर चेन?
यस
यस. एंड रिमेंबर वन, दिस अथॉरिटी, द लेवल ऑफ अथॉरिटी फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम, इट डिक्रीजेस एंड देयर शुड बी वन वे कम्युनिकेशन. रिमेंबर दिस ओनली. अंडरस्टूड?
यस मैम.
Okay, any query about any principle? Okay, we'll have 3 minutes. So in the 3 minutes, we'll take a small recap. Just tell me fast what you understood about the particular principle. Just tell me in one sentence, one or two sentences, isn't it? Okay, we'll start with the division of work. Division of work means? Yes, try to recall.
Divide the work between the employers, ma'am.
Yes, it is nothing but the main work. It is divided into the sub work or the small task. Okay, it can be divided individually or it can be divided among particular group. And it is basically, it is related to task specialization, isn't it? We took one example, that is the subjects are divided among the different teachers. Okay, that is nothing but the divisions of work. Then authority, yes, authority and
yes. Responsibility of work.
Yes, authority and responsibility. So what do you understood by authority? Authority means what? Yes.
Which have some yes. Which have give permission to work.
See, authority means
authority means it is a type of responsibility of a person, ma'am.
Yes, see, authorized person is always responsible for his task. Okay, so if I am having particular authority, so I only the person will be responsible for the particular task given to me by my authority, isn't it? So in authority, again, there is a, we can say, scalar chain. So authority and the scalar chain, see, authority and scalar chain, they are closely related principles. Then discipline means it's nothing but the code of conduct, the specific rules and regulations laid by the particular organization, and each one should be accountable, each one should follow all the rules and regulations. So maybe there is a variation. Aap aise nahi bol sakte. See, principal को खाली एक ही काम नहीं था कि खाली आपके कॉलेज में आओ या फिर आपके स्कूल में आओ वही काम करो. प्रिंसिपल को बहुत सारे काम रहते, तो वो ऐसे नहीं, आप ऐसे नहीं बोल सकते कि एज अ टीचर अगर मैं 10 बजे जा रही हूँ तो प्रिंसिपल को 10 बजे, हो सकता है आपसे पहले 8 बजे प्रिंसिपल कहीं और जाके दूसरा काम करके आए हो. तो डिसिप्लिन और रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन इट वैरीज लेवल वाइज, इजंट इट? एंड सी, फॉर डिसिप्लिन व्हाट वी आर गिविंग, वी आर अप्लाइंग पेनाल्टीज. अभी कुछ देर पहले किसी ने पेनाल्टी ये शब्द, दैट कम्स अंडर डिसिप्लिन. So penalties, it can be in the form of memos, it can be in the form of late marks. Okay, that is nothing but the discipline. Okay, then the stability of tenure, yes, that is nothing but the job security. Is spirit the cop, there should be. So here, what is the role of organization? Organization encourage the harmony and good relationship between the employees. Unity of command means what? Yes. Unity of command means here the orders are given by only one person.
One person.
So remaining persons who are under that person, they should follow orders of the particular person. Okay. And then unity of direction, there should be proper action plan. That there should be a goal and objectives of that particular organization. So all the employees who are the part of that organization, they will get direction where to go, how to go. Remuneration, so here we are talking in Hindi, we call it as a mandhan. So remuneration means what? As per the quality of work, the proper mandhan or proper remuneration should be given to the employees. Then next is subordination of individual interest to the general interest. So who will tell me about this? Yes. Subordination of individual interest to the general interest. So here we have to take care of the
organization.
Yes, benefits.
Benefits of
yes, benefits and gains of organization. So before खुद को ये देने से पहले हमें किसको priority देनी है? We have to take care of organization. There is no chance to think about our personal gains. Okay. Then centralization, this is related to the decision making. If any authority is taking decision by his own without taking opinions of the other, that is nothing but the centralization. And if that person is taking opinions of the others, then that is decentralization. But basically here FIOS focuses on the centralized process of decision making. Then next is scalar chain, that is the chain of the authority. Okay. And according to Fiol, there should be one way process of communication. Order means it is somehow it is related to the staffing function of management. That is nothing but the right place at the right place at the right place, right person at the right place. That is nothing but the order. Equity, everyone should be treated equally in the organization. Initiative, and the last one, that is initiative. If the management is encouraging, is giving motivation to the employees, then automatically they will take initiative and they will try to do extra work or new tasks of that organization. So this is all about the principles of management given by the Henry Fiol. Understood about the principles of management and how it is, how all these principles are applicable in the school or in any education institutions? Okay. Yes, ma'am. In the next lecture, we will continue another theory of management by the Peter Drucker. Okay. Now it's 12:48. My time is over. Now I'm going to stop here.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am. Yeah, I'm Geeta, ma'am.
Okay, Geeta, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Very good afternoon.
So, I'm sorry, afternoon. It's
okay. So before leaving, I'm making you host. Just wait for a while.
Okay.
Okay, Geeta ma'am, now you are host. I'm going to leave this meeting. Okay, dear students, bye-bye. See you in the next session. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.